Hello, everybody. I'm Lynn Burkhead from MajorLeagueFishing.com. I'm with Mike McClelland, and Mike McClelland is a very successful angler, and he's a very successful angler for several reasons. Number one, he's pretty good at fishing. Number two, he's pretty good at picking the right bait. There was something called a War Eagle spinnerbait, as I recall, that began to factor into the success in your career. Spinnerbaiting is something the young guys, that's old school. They don't like that. They don't do the spinnerbait. Why?
The biggest thing is there's so many other baits out there now that are so much more realistic looking. Back when I started fishing, there weren't many swim baits. I mean, we had crankbaits, we had spinnerbaits, and we had plastic worms. A spinnerbait, to me, then was the ultimate swim bait. You know, it could be a bream, it could be a shad, it could be anything you wanted it to be that the fish fed on. And then they start making all these soft plastic swim baits that are so much more realistic looking. And there's no denying the fish really like those soft plastic swim baits. But the thing that I'm starting to see finally, and I've said it for 4 or 5 years now, a spinnerbait will reemerge. And it has. You look at what's happened just here in the last couple years. Rick Klun almost wins Lake Texoma last year throwing a spinnerbait. He hurt my feelings though. He got up on stage and he said there wasn't anybody in the competition that understood spinnerbait fishing like he did.
Yes.
And that kind of hurt my feelings, and it actually kind of put a fire back in me to start throwing a spinnerbait more. I generally always have one tied on no matter where we go. If the conditions present themselves for me to throw it, I'm going to throw it. You know, it's not all about just picking a spinnerbait out of a package and throwing it, because you've got to understand blade combinations. You've got to understand what the different blades do to a spinnerbait. You've got to understand, you know, what you're trying to accomplish, and then match that presentation. The biggest thing about spinnerbait fishing is understanding you got to pick the right bait for the right conditions to be successful in catching.
You mentioned you thought the spinnerbait would reemerge, and I got to ask you something. I've always had a pet theory that fish get conditioned
Absolutely.
To seeing certain baits on heavily pressured waters. I've always thought, like you, that the spinnerbait would reemerge because so many people have quit fishing it.
Exactly.
That at some point the fish are going to reengage it.
And that's exactly what I think is starting to happen. You know, you would pull up to the ramp and 8 out of 10 guys would have a spinnerbait laying on their deck.
And now it's about 2 out of 10.
When you pull up to a ramp today, it is very seldom. Well, if there's 20 boats at a ramp, you may see 1 or 2 spinnerbaits. So I definitely believe what you just said is for sure the truth. I mean, fish aren't seeing it as much, and I think it's a bait that's definitely going to start shining again.
Spinnerbaiting is something that Mike McClelland has used throughout his career. It might be old school to some folks watching this, but it's not old school to one of the best in the business. You're pretty good at your craft, sir. If you'd like to learn more about the tips and the techniques of our anglers like Mike McClelland, you can go to our website, MajorLeagueFishing.com.